Hello, my friends. I'm Jeff Beveridge, project management and leadership trainer with Corner Post Management Experts, and I'm here today to serve up another delicious, refreshing knowledge snack. Today, we're going to nibble on the topic of critical path management, a subset of project schedule management. And those of you who have maybe in the past sat for the PMP exam might have studied the incredibly lengthy, incredibly cumbersome, incredibly burdensome manual methods for calculating the critical path, right? We make our forward pass through the project schedule. We make our backward pass through the project schedule. We calculate the float, the early finish, the late finish, the early start, the late start, so forth. Good news, my friends, we're not going to do that today because I'm recording this in the year 2020 and we have robots for this sort of thing now. What was commonly lacking in critical path management training in the past, in my humble opinion, was that we spent all of this time on the cumbersome manual method for calculating the critical path without much discussion of why a project manager actually needs to know the critical path. So we'll leave it to another video another day to talk about calculating the critical path manually. What I want you to know is that your schedule management tool, such as Microsoft Project or Primavera or whatever schedule management tool you're using, should have the capability to tell you which path is the critical path. What we're going to talk about today is why would you want to know that information. So first and foremost, what is the critical path? It's the longest possible path through the project. Just very, very quickly, we've got a simple project schedule network diagram up here. I'm not going to walk all the way through it, but what we see represented with red is that is the critical path on our project. There are three possible paths we could take, right? We could take the top path, following along the red here. We could take that path right through the center. We'll call it our middle path. We could take this bottom path here that comes up and around through our project schedule. And something that I commonly have to talk about with students and kind of alleviate confusion on, this is not the shortcut through the project. This is not which activities will we do. We're going to do all of these activities. But what the critical path tells us is which of these is the longest possible path through the project. Because why we would want to know that is if it's the longest path through the project, if the critical path takes exactly as long as the project, that means that any delay to the critical path will mean a delay to the project end date. Non-critical paths, these other two paths through our project, we have what we call float or slack. You could think of this as we have wiggle room, right? If there's a delay along the critical path, that will delay, by definition, that will delay the project end date as a whole. But a delay along a non-critical path might not necessarily delay the project as a whole. Because the critical path is longer, that means that on these non-critical paths, that means that we have some of that wiggle room. We have maybe a little bit more room to play catch up if we're delayed. So the critical path, the longest possible path through the project, again, why do we want to know that? The critical path requires close management and close attention, right? If a delay along the critical path means a delay to the project as a whole, that means for us as project managers that when push comes to shove and all of these activities are at risk of being delayed, it helps us focus our attention on where do we want to give most of the resources, where do we want to give most of our attention to avoiding that delay, right? If I have to choose between a critical path and non-critical path activity to give some extra resources to, I would probably want to choose the critical path activity because I know if it's delayed, the project as a whole might be delayed, whereas this non-critical path activity, they might be able to suffer a delay. They might be able to withstand a delay without affecting the project end date as a whole. So the critical path is where we want to focus our attention and perhaps where we want to focus our resources. And then the last thing that I want you to know about the critical path is that the critical path can change, right? If one of these non-critical path activities is delayed for long enough, that path could overtake the critical path. So as a project manager, we want to be aware not only what is the current critical path, but are we at risk of the critical path changing, right? If I'm working on an older version of the critical path, I might be making the wrong decision about those resource allocations, right? I want to know what is the current critical path, because that is something that could change throughout the life of the project. And I want to wrap up by emphasizing that this term critical, when we're talking critical path, critical has a very specific definition in schedule management, meaning it's the path of activities that will take us the longest, right? In other contexts of project management, sometimes we use the word critical to mean important, right? Most consequential, most visible, something like that. Recognize that in critical path management, this is a schedule management approach, and that term critical only means the longest, right? So what we're saying here is that this activity takes longer than this activity. I'm not saying, and we're not saying, that it is any more or less important than that activity, right? Maybe I have a non-critical path activity that is very, very important. It's a big deal, and maybe even a bigger deal than some of my critical path activities. But when we say critical related to the schedule and related to critical path, we simply mean the path that will take the longest going throughout the project. Got it? Wonderful. As always, you can go check out more knowledge snacks and knowledge feasts at cornerpostmanagement.com. You can click like, subscribe, follow, share, whatever buttons they've got on whatever platform you're watching this video on that would help us and help us share this knowledge with others. Again, you can visit me anytime. You can visit the company anytime. Corner Post Management Experts at cornerpostmanagement.com. Hope to see you very, very soon.